Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. Wassalamu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa aqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Rabbi zidna ilma warzuqna rahma. Alright, so welcome back to class MEC 2.1 for fluid mechanics. So inshallah today we will continue our class on chapter 1 of fluid mechanics. Okay, in this chapter we'll be looking at the introduction and the basic concept of in a fluid mechanics, where we'll be looking at characteristic of fluids and the continuum model. We'll be looking at the fluid properties and the scope and the classification of fluid flow. Okay, the allocation time is 3 hours, so we'll be finishing our chapter 1 in this class. Okay. Alright, so for introduction, what is a fluid mechanics? So fluid mechanics is the science that deals with the behavior of fluids at rest, which is fluid static, or in motion, which is fluid dynamics, and the interaction of fluid with solid and other fluid at the boundary. So we are look. So in this fluid mechanics class, we'll be looking at the behavior of fluid at rest and the behavior of fluid in motion lah. Okay. Alright. So what is a fluid? Okay, fluid in definition is a substance which is deformed continuously under the action of shearing force, however small they are. So fluid is a substance that deform continuously. So this is the keywords lah, deform continuously. Okay, and then we'll be looking next we'll be looking at, on pressure. So what is pressure? So pressure can be defined as a component of stress or components of force over area. Okay. In a fluid at rest, normal stress, we call it pressure, and has zero shear stress because supporting walls of fluid limiting shear stress. So in a normal stress, for example, we have water. Okay, if you have a board, floating board, and you press the board, okay, the pressure that you give to the board, we call it normal pressure lah. Normal pressure. But, but if you have a board and then this water, and you press the board with an angle and the board will be moving, okay, along the water and also giving pressure. Okay, this pressure, the component pressure in the x in y direction, we call it normal lah, normal pressure. Normal pressure, y, the component in x direction, we call it shear stress. Shear stress. Okay, this is the difference between the pressure and shear stress. Okay. Alright, so what is the component of pressure? So pressure is can be defined as a force over area. Okay, force over area. And yeah, okay, this is sigma. Sigma stands for normal stress, while tau stands for shear stress. Both same. Is for force over area. Both the same, force over area. Okay, alright, so next we'll be looking at system and control volume. Okay, what is system? Okay, system is called defined as a quantity of matter or a region in space chosen for studies. Okay, what control volume? Okay, so what is so that is dual genus system. We have two types of system, which is closed system and open system. Okay, closed system, we have no mass can cross the boundary. Okay, for open system, mass can cross the boundary. Okay, other than that, energy can across the boundary for both system. Okay, volume for a closed system does not fit. Sama juga dengan control volume ataupun open system. Okay, alright, so this is system. Okay, this is a system. Okay, this is a system. Okay, system, this inilah area kita nak study ni. Okay, the line outside the system, okay, we call it boundary. Okay, outside of the line, we call it surrounding. Okay, for example, alright, for example, we have a cup of coffee. Okay, cup of coffee. So, the cup here is the boundary. Okay, boundary. Okay, cup the boundary. Okay, the coffee inside the cup. So, coffee inside the cup. Ini adalah kita punya sistem. Okay, the area outside the cup, we call it surrounding. Okay. So, here is system. So, surrounding the mass or region outside the system. Boundary is the real or imaginary surface that separate the system from the surrounding. Okay. So, here is a closed system, example of closed system. Here we have an open system. So, for closed system, the mass cannot be transferred. Okay, for open system, mass can be transferred. Here we have a hole here. So, the mass can come in and come out. But for the both system, energy can be transferred. Okay. Alright, so next, we'll be looking at the characteristic of a system. Okay, characteristic of system. Expressed by properties of a system. Okay, properties, any characteristic of system, they usually have mass, volume, temperature, pressure, and density. Okay, their properties can be divided into two, which is intensive properties or the extensive properties. Okay, we have two properties lah. Okay, extensive or intensive. Okay, what is the difference between extensive and intensive? Okay, intensive, those that are dependent of the mass of the system, such as temperature, pressure, and density. Extensive properties are those whose values depend on the size or the extent of the system. Okay, for example lah, kita ada coffee tadi kan. And then we have another cup, which is have nothing lah, kosong lah. Kosong, okay, we put half of the volume of the mass daripada coffee 1 to cup 1 to cup 2. So the volume become half. Okay, 1 half, the cup 2 pun jadi half. So the mass also become half. But the temperature, pressure is still the same. Okay, temperature, pressure dia tak sama, tak berubah. So okay, the volume that change, the value that change when the mass change, we call it extensive properties, while the unchanged properties, we call it intensive properties. Okay, that's the difference between extensive and intensive properties. Okay, alright. So, this is an example application of fluid mechanics, which is, we can here we can look at artificial heart, we have a waterfall, we have a power plant, boat, airplane, aircraft, we have a human body, cars, we have a wind turbine, piping, plumbing system, and also industrial application and other application. Okay, now we'll be looking at the fluid as continuum model. So what is continuum model? Okay, continuum model can be described as a homogeneous matter. Okay, a homogeneous matter with no holes. Apa dia maksudkan dengan homogeneous matter with no holes? Okay, for example. For example, we have a pipe. We have a pipe. Okay, we have here pipe. And when you open the pipe, the water will fall. Macam ni kan? Straight form. Straight macam ni. Water tak akan jatuh. Macam ni. Petak macam ni. Petak macam ni. Petak macam ni. So, bila dia jatuh straight macam ni, we call it continuum model. Okay, maksudnya dia berterusan jatuh. Continuum model. Dia bukan macam ni ya. So, this is continuum model. Apabila dia jatuh macam ni, dia adalah continuum model. Okay. Very simple. Okay, for the properties of fluid, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 properties of fluid, which is density, specific gravity, we have a specific weight, specific volume, dynamic viscosity, and also kinematic viscosity. Okay, density, kita tahulah density eh. Density is mass over volume. The unit is kilogram over meter cubic. We have specific volume. Specific volume is the inverse of the density, which is volume over mass. And we can write also as 1 over rho. Okay, the unit will be the cubic over kilogram. Okay, now we have specific weight. Specific weight is gamma. This is gamma equal to rho g. The unit is Newton over meter cubic. And we have another properties, we call it specific gravity, or we write it as Sg equal to rho over rho H2O. Okay, rho H2O ni biasanya adalah 1000 lah. 1000, okay. Alright, next. Okay, right, that's all for the properties of the fluids. Okay, we have four. Another two is kinematic viscosity and dynamic viscosity. We'll be looking at it later. Okay, now we'll be looking at the density of ideal gas. Okay, density of ideal gas. Okay, equation of state. Apa dikatakan equation of state? Is very simple. PV over RT. Okay, V here bukan volume. This is specific volume equal to RT. Okay, or you can write it as, since specific volume ni sama juga dengan 1 over rho. So, jadi P 1 over rho equal to RT sama juga dengan P equal to rho RT. So, kalau kita boleh macam inilah. Equation of state. Equation of state is P V kecil equal to RT. So, since V ni ada specific volume equal to 1 over rho. So, masukkan dalam sini awak akan dapat P over rho equal to RT. Ataupun akan dapat juga P equal to rho RT. So, this is the equation of state for ideal, ideal gas. Okay, next. Okay, here we have PV equal to MRT. Okay, MRT. Kenapa boleh jadi PV equal MRT? Very simple. Because rho equal apa? Rho equal to mass over volume. So, kalau awak tukar kat sini. So, P equal to mass over volume RT. So, tukarkan balik. Akan jadi PV equal MRT. So, this is the three type of satu. So, we have another one, two, and three. So, tiga lah. Okay. R ni is gas constant. Okay, tiga. Ideal gas. The gas state equation. Okay. Okay, this is an example lah. Bagi example kat sini. The density, specific gravity. Okay, jadi kat sini, example one. Determine the density, specific gravity, and the mass of the air in a room whose dimension 4 times 5 times 6 at 100 kilopascal and 225 degree Celsius. Okay, kita ada room 4 times 6 times 5. Okay, kita ada rooms. So, kita ada room 4, 6, 5. Okay, kita ada room 4 times 6 times 5. Okay, sorry. 5 yang ke bawah tu lah. 4, 6, 5. Okay, 4, 6, 5. So, 5 kat sini lah. Okay, 4, 6, 5. Okay, kita apa kat sini? Determine the density, specific gravity and the mass of air. Okay, mass of air, the pressure kat sini 100 kilopascal, the temperature 25 degree Celsius. Okay, we have the want to density. And then they want to find specific gravity and mass. Specific gravity apa dia? Sg lah, specific gravity dan juga mass. Which kat sini kita ada dia punya pressure is 100 kilopascal and the temperature is 25 degree Celsius. So nak pakai apa? So, pakai okay, apa ni? Cari ni. So, since dia kata kat sini, air. Air ni adalah ideal gas. So, since dia ada gas, gunalah equation PV equal RT ni untuk cari. So, since kita nak cari, so R ni adalah gas constant. Gas constant awak boleh dapat daripada table atau research pada internet lah. Nilai dia berapa. Okay, so kita nak cari rho. Okay, nak cari rho. So, rho simple je lah. Guna dalam equation yang ada rho kat dalam dia. So, kita guna P equal to rho RT. So, we want to find rho. Rho equal to RT. Sorry. RT. Oh, RT over P. Okay, P awak dah ada nilai 100 kilopascal. Nilai R, awak boleh search kat internet lah. Ataupun tengok dalam table. Okay, untuk air. Air, dia punya gas constant nama dia. Okay, T, we have temperature. Temperature dalam degree Celsius. Sekarang, you need to change it into Kelvin. Okay, cari tadi lah. Cuma dari Kelvin. So, for your homework. So, find the rho. Okay, next, you must find the Sg. So, to find the Sg, very simple. So since Sg equal to rho over rho H2O, so since rho H2O ni equal to 1000 kilogram over meter cubic. So masukkan sajalah nilai rho yang berdapat daripada equation ni tadi, okay, ke dalam ni. And then we have found mass. Okay, mass boleh guna juga. P equal to PV equal to MRT. Okay, guna jelah rumus ni untuk cari mass. Okay. So, this is your homework. Find the value of rho, specific gravity and mass. Okay, this is your first homework. First homework. Okay, this is first homework. Okay, next. Okay, alright. We already have here. Okay, so you don't need to solve it since we already have here. So just look at. Yelah, tapi still, you must submit eh. You must submit the your first homework by looking at here. Eh? Okay, for example. Okay, alright. So next we'll be looking at the example here. Okay, example 2. Okay, example 2 dia beritahu apa? What volume of castor oil? Sg 1.258. Okay, we have castor oil. Okay, we have here castor oil. Okay, dia punya Sg dia adalah 1.258. Okay, castor oil 1.258. And then weight the same as 0.020 meter cubic. Weight the same 0.020 meter cubic. Meter cubic. Apa benda ni? Meter cubic apa? Glycerin. Okay, glycerin dia kata. Ini adalah glycerin. Glycerin. So glycerin. Okay, specific weight for glycerin adalah 8.77 kilonewton over the cubic. So ni kita ada specific weight. Specific weight apa tadi? Gamma. Gamma apa sama apa? Rho g. Okay, eh? So specific weight nilai dia adalah 8.77 kilonewton over meter cubic. So soalan dia, so cari volume. What volume? So volume untuk castor oil. Okay. Volume, sorry, so need to find the volume supaya nilai apa volume apabila sama lah, okay. Okay, dia kata kat sini would weight the same, okay, would weight the same as 0.020 meter cubic of glycerin, okay. Alright. So apa maklumat yang kita ada? Kita ada maklumat yang pertama, we have Sg, and we have V1 kita tak tahu V1, okay, tapi kita tahu V2 berapa. V2 0.020 meter cubic. Okay, we have gamma tu lah untuk castor oil ni, ni SG1. Okay, so soalan dia, dia nak cari volume. Okay, volume dia yang sama weight dengan castor oil pada 0.20 meter cubic. So macam mana kita nak cari? Okay, so macam mana kita nak cari? So very simple. So first of all, apa yang kita kena buat adalah kita kena cari ini. Kita kena cari mass dia berapa. Kenapa kita nak perlu cari mass dia berapa? Supaya, okay, kenapa nak cari mass? Alright. Macam mana kita nak, so macam mana kita nak cari volume daripada properties yang kita belajar tadi. So yang good ada volume, ada dua kan. Sama ada specific volume 1 over rho ataupun kita guna rho equal to M over mass. Okay, eh? Kita tahu yang density tidak berubah. Okay, density tidak berubah tapi mass dan volume boleh berubah. Okay, so sekarang since kita tak tahu mass berapa, so we need to find the rho dulu berapa untuk SG1. So SG1, rho dia simple je lah, equal to rho over rho H2O. Rho H2O tahu nilai dia adalah 1000. So jadi masukkan saja nilai SG1, ada nilai dia adalah 1.258. So sama juga dengan rho. Okey, rho dia kita tak tahu, kita nak cari sekarang rho, tapi kita tahu H2O 1000. So just darat saja. So kita dapat rho equal to 1258 kilogram over meter kubik. Okey, kita dah tahu nilai ni. So next nak cari mass. Mass. So macam mana cari mass? Itu soalan dia beritahu kat kita yang weight the same. Weight the same dengan glycerin. So maksud dia castor oil ni weight dia sama dengan glycerin. So maksud dia M1 akan sama dengan M2. So kita nak cari M1 sekarang. So kita tahu nilai sama dengan M2. So M2 dia daripada mana nak cari? Okey, macam mana kita nak cari M2? Simple sahaja. So kat sini dia beritahu kita volume, dia beritahu kita specific weight. Specific weight sama dengan apa? OG. So macam nak kira? Simple. So saya padam dulu. Lepas saya pergi kat sini. So we have volume 2 equal to 0.020 meter cubic, and we know gamma equal to 8.77 times 10^3 newton over meter cubic. Okay. Dan kita tahu juga nilai. So kita nak tahu nilai M lah. Kita nak tahu nilai M 2 berapa. So kita tahu gamma equal to rho G. Rho sama dengan apa? Rho equal to mass over volume. Volume kita tahu nilai. Alright. So rho, rho boleh cari. Okay, rho mass. Kita tahu mass ni, eh. Mass ni. So masuk saja nilai rumus ni. Gamma equal to M2 over V2 times dengan G. So kita tahu M2. So M2 equal to gamma times V2 over G. So G ni adalah gravity acceleration, which is 9.81 meter second. Okay, yang ni nilai dia awak tahu, nilai dia yang ni. Dan yang ni awak tahu juga nilai dia adalah yang ni. So find M2 and then we got M1. If you find M1, you can find the volume 1 lah. Okay, eh? Berapa kita nak cari volume 1? Okay, this is your second homework. Second homework. Okay, calculate this problem. Okay, and then submit lah. Alright. So second homework. So you have two homework. One yang tadi, yang air tadi tu. And second, we have ialah castor oil punya problem. Okay. Okay, and third one, we have a cylindrical container of 180 millimeter diameter is filled to a depth 100 millimeter with a fuel oil. Okay, the oil has a mass 1.76 kilogram. Calculate its density, specific weight and specific gravity. Okay, kita ada container. Container dia punya diameter 180 mm dan juga kedalaman dia ataupun tinggi dia 100 mm. So we have a container. Container silindrikal kata ya. Silindrikal maksudnya silindrikal lah macam ni. So dia punya diameter adalah 180 mm. Ketinggian dia adalah 100 mm. Okay, sorry. We have 100 mm. So, and then dia cakap kat sini, the oil has a mass of 1.76 kilogram. So, 1.76 kilogram. Okay, 76 kilogram. Calculate density, specific weight and specific gravity. So, calculate density. So, calculate density, specific weight, specific gravity. So tiga benda lah dia nak. So macam mana kita nak cari? Very simple. Okay. Apa? Rho. Rho equal to M over V. M awak dah tahu nilai dia berapa. V awak boleh kira. Okay. Macam nak kira V? Pi R square times juga dengan H lah. Okay. V sebab dia cylindrical. Pi R square times juga dengan H ketinggian dia. Okay. Make sure awak tukar unit 1 H0 kepada meter. Okay, berapa meter tukar? 100 mm. Berapa meter? Unit tukar setiasa. Okay, gamma macam mana kira? Gamma boleh guna rho equal to, sorry, gamma equal to rho g. Okay, rho, dia awak kira. Maksudnya saya nilai kat sini. Okay, and then we have sg. Okay, macam mana kira sg? Sg equal to rho over rho H2O. So, since kita dah tahu nilai rho nanti, bahagikan saja dengan 1000 orang akan dapat nilai sg berapa. So, this is your third homework. Third homework. Okay. Alright, so next we'll be looking at viscosity and drag force. Okay, viscosity ni apa? Secara mudahnya adalah properties that represent internal resistance of fluid to motion or fluidity. Viscosity ni adalah kelikatan. Okay, kelikatan. Bahasa Melayu, kelikatan. Drag force apa? Drag force is a flowing fluid exert on body in a flow direction. The magnitude of the force depend in part on viscosity. Okay, drag force dia depends kepada viscosity. Apa tu drag force? Drag force ni adalah force yang berlawanan lah. Kalau kereta dia bergerak ke depan, force yang bergerak ke belakang tu yang buat kereta jadi perlahan, itu adalah drag force. So, for example, we have a car. Okay, we have a car. The car is moving forward. But we have a resistance. Yeah, resistance for the air. So, resistance ni kita panggil drag force. Okay, eh? Sama juga dengan kapal terbang. We have kapal terbang kat sini contoh. Kapal terbang. Dia moving forward. Tapi dia ada resistance pada air kat belakang. So, yang kita panggil drag force. Sama juga dengan ikan duduk dalam air. Dia berenang ke depan. Ikan, eh? Kita ada ikan. So, ikan ni berenang ke depan. Tapi dia ada force yang perlahankan ikan tu daripada bergerak. Dia panggil drag force. Okay, resistance lah. Okay. Okay, next we'll be looking at shear stress and shear force. Okay, apa itu shear stress, apa itu shear force. Okay, shear stress secara mudahnya boleh dikatakan tau equal to mu. Mu ni adalah dynamic viscosity, eh, du over dy. Okay, force apa dia? Force kita tahu tadi. Stress sama juga dengan force over area. So, force equal juga stress times juga dengan ialah. So, shear force times shear force adalah shear stress times juga dengan A, ataupun boleh rewrite balik sebagai U dy. Mu du dy. Okay. So, kita tulis balik macam ni. Shear stress sama juga dengan tau. Sama juga dengan mu du dy. Okay. Kat mana mu? Kat mana du dy? Okay, for example lah, kita ada pipe. Okay, ada pipe. Okay. Okay, so we have dalam pipe ni adalah satu batang kat sini bergerak macam ni. Okay. So, kita nak cari stress pada plate ni. Plate yang duduk di tengah pipe ni. Stress. Okay. So, jarak ke sini biasanya kita panggil dia nilai dy lah. Ini dy. Ini dy. Mu. Mu tu apa? Mu ni adalah ni. Dense kinematic viscosity. Ataupun dynamic viscosity. Eh. Yang ni mu adalah dynamic viscosity lah. Kalau mu. Ada dua jenis viscosity, which is mu dynamic viscosity. And we have another one, mu kecil. We call it kinematic viscosity. Okay, kinematic viscosity. Okay, mu nilai dia dah fix. Dia fix, eh, ada dalam table. Okay, tapi ni, kalau nu, ni nu, eh, kita panggil nu. Nu equal to 1. Mu over rho lah. Mu over rho. Okay, nilai nu. Okay, so kinematic viscosity adalah viscosity, eh, kelikatan. So, du ni adalah du adalah velocity, eh. Du adalah velocity. Okay, du. So, ini adalah du dy. Okay. Alright. So, kalau shear force, this is stress. So, shear force, apa dia? So since force, kita tahu force equal to pressure over A, ataupun juga force pressure, stress shear stress over A. So kita nak cari shear force, so tau. So F, so F tau. Sorry, we have tau. Saya terbalik eh, sorry. We have pressure, force over area. We have shear force over area juga. Okay, so we want to find the shear force. So, shear force F equal to tau times juga dengan A, area. Okay, area. Okay, macam ni lah. So, since kita tahu tau equal to mu du dy. So, masukkan saja F equal to mu du dy times juga dengan A. So we have here lah. Okay. And then next. Okay, so this one, apa beza nak tengok. So we have here is a shear stress times the deformation. Okay, kalau fluid yang kalau graph dia straight macam ni, kita panggil Newtonian fluid eh. Straight macam ni. Tapi kalau the curve macam ni, kita panggil non-Newtonian fluid. Okay, non-Newtonian maksud dia. What beza non-Newtonian fluid dengan Newtonian fluid is that Newtonian fluid, when you have a brush, for example, we have a brush, we insert it in water, and then when we tangkap brush tu, air tu akan jatuh daripada brush tu. Tapi apabila awak ambil brush, awak masukkan dia ke dalam cat, tapi cat tu akan melekat pada brush tu. So, bila dia melekat pada brush, cecair itu kita panggil dia non-Newtonian fluid. Itu cara kita nak bezakan Newtonian dan juga non-Newtonian fluid. Okay, alright. So, seperti saya cakap tadi, kinematic viscosity is equal to nu, ni nu, mu over rho. Okay, alright. This is an example of example of the problem involving the shear stress. Okay, shear stress. Okay, yang ini kita akan selesaikan pada next class. Ha? Okay, untuk hari ini sampai kat sini saja kelas kita. Okay, jangan lupa untuk submit 3 homework yang saya bagi tadi tu. Okay, just submit dalam bentuk PDF. Dalam bentuk PDF. Nanti saya akan beritahu macam mana awak nak submit. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you very much for listening. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.